Hello there and welcome to this week's Business Roundup. My name is Vaila Oksasira and joining me is Paul Busharizi, a business journalist with a new vision, and he's our analyst tonight. So Paul, let's start off with the current flooding that's happening in the country, and also this has been attributed to human activities that have destroyed the environment. And we have the latest being Katonga River flooding and cutting off part of Masaka-Kampala Highway. And so we have a lot of transport problems at the moment that won't allow food and other produce to come to Kampala. So talk to us about the impact of this and also show us the bigger picture of what this means about our access to other parts of the country as the economy.
No, I mean, most immediately I can imagine, I think it's realistic to expect we will see some price increases in food. We get a lot of our matoke from beyond Katonga. We get a lot of beef from beyond Katonga. We get milk and grain, some grain like beans and I think millet and things like that. That's for us in Kampala. But then there's the other way. So that road is a main highway we can say Eastern Congo, because this one goes on until Kasese and thereabouts. Rwanda, a major part of our hinterland is that side. So you can imagine there's going to be pain felt not only in Kampala, but around the region. It also highlights how bad our transport system, in the sense that we should have probably had water transport. So you'd probably send all our stuff via Port Bell to Masaka or something like that. Or we probably have a railway, which would be alternative. Probably wouldn't, the railway didn't cross over the bridge. So, you know, it just exposes how dependent we are on, you know, this road when we shouldn't. I mean, given all the economic activity that goes up and down this road.
Yeah, part of the produce that is going to be cut off from Kampala markets is going to be milk that comes majorly from Barra farms. And now, speaking about milk, staying with it for a little bit, there was a report coming in from a Pearl Dairy Farm, that the makers of Lato Milk, who say that milk in Uganda has the potential to become the biggest revenue earner for the country. Do you believe this? And also, what do we have to do to be able to see this come to reality?
Well, we could become I remember a figure, I think a year or two ago, that we're already the biggest exporter of milk on the continent. We export more milk than anyone else on this continent. And that's just been a recent development. We can be even bigger. One of the reasons why we are not as big as we should is that 80% of Uganda's milk, 80% of our milk production is not processed. We drink our milk raw. Now, the problem with that is that you can't export raw milk. And the standards, if we get more people to drink processed milk, our standards improve and then we can export that. One way like Kenya did was to create what they called school milk program. So they offered, I think, all the children in primary school free milk. I think it used to be twice or thrice a week. But what that did is it increased the capacity of Kenyans, of Kenyan manufacturing, to process milk. Second thing it did is that it developed a taste for processed milk among Kenyans. Therefore, there's a market within Kenya, and then which market can easily be transferred. So maybe as a starter, we need to force people to start drinking processed milk. Because if 80% of our milk is unprocessed, we're in trouble.
So Paul, let's now switch gears. We talk about the Stanbic Bank Processors Manufacturers Index, and this has been tracking job creation, especially within the private sector, for the last 6 to 7 years, and they noticed that several jobs have been created and they have gone beyond 50%. So when you talk about job creation, is it really something that translates directly to people's earning, and we see that people are getting better, especially in their livelihoods, or is it just investors mentioning how many people they're hiring regardless of how much they're paying them and how much their take home is?
Yeah, so I think it's a producer and manufacturer index. You talk about the PMI that Stanbic has been tracking for the last 7 or so years. So the way they do it is they go to factories and ask questions about their production capacity, how much of their production are they using, how much are they producing, you know, how are sales and stuff like that, as an indicator of where the economy is going. So in that index, they pointed out that because manufacturing is increasing, we need to get more people to man, you know, man the lines or help with logistics and stuff like that. It's a good thing. Given that we've come out of COVID, where we had for 2 years, you know, the economy really kind of flattened out, it's promising that we're getting out of that COVID lull.
Okay, so awesome. So thank you very much, Paul. It's been a pleasure having you for the Business Roundup once again, and we hope to see you next week. Also, dear viewers, thank you very much for making time. This is what we had from the world of business, and we shall catch you again Friday back to the news.